Hello guys, thanks for stopping by the channel again. It has been a while without recording anything here, but I'm back. I'm too busy creating work and work in the studio, but it's nice to be back here. In this tutorial today, I'm gonna just show to you guys a little bit how to work with modifiers in fields. Really nice skill and how you can create very creative animation and pretty much like anything, but those tools are very powerful, really great for you to do anything that you want to do. Again, thanks for stopping by. Subscribe to the channel if you haven't yet. It would be great to keep supporting my new channel. All right, so let's just dive it in play with those tools. Okay, all right, so I'm gonna start with a prefab. Let me just start a new document, actually. Start fresh. All right, it's gonna start with a prefab cube. Not much on that. I'm gonna leave it this same size of 200 centimeters, which is really, really big, but later we're gonna change a little bit the dimension of it. Okay, I'm gonna get a cloner. I'm gonna make the cube a child of the cloner. As you can see, it's pretty, pretty big now, but I will change the size, and you can see here, I can change the size. I'm gonna just make, let me start with 100, 100, 100. Pretty, pretty nice, just 100, pretty big still, but demand of the computer that you have, the machine that you have, you wanna make this even smaller. I have a pretty decent computer that I'm working with, so it's pretty fine the size. Actually, let's go 50, 50, 50. There you go, fair. I'm gonna go to my cloner, and I will bring all that together. So 57 centimeters. Let's just put 60. Right there. Oops, 60. All right, cool. And 60 here, so that will be very nicely can seem the same distance between each one of them. And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna make this a little bit more. I'm gonna clone a little bit more of this guy. Oh, right here, hold on, my window is a little bit smaller. Let me just bring this a little bit here so I actually can see my tools good. Right there, I think that's pretty fine. 6, pretty decent. Right there, that's the amount of cloned cubes. That'll be fun to work with. All right, now modifiers and effectors. All right, so effectors, you can see that in my cloner, I have an effector menu here. There's nothing in effectors here. So effectors, you will find effectors right on here. These are the effectors tools. Okay, the field tools is right here, and you can find the field tools in a different location. I will show to you in a second, but for you to add an effector, there's so many ways that you can do. You can just find an effector, select it, and just choose the effector that you want. You're gonna go to the cloner, and you can just grab it and drag it here in effectors, or let me delete this, or you select the cloner, okay, and you just find the effector and just click it on it, and it will automatically be added. Okay, so I'm gonna be working with the plane. So I'm gonna add the plane there. So if you go back to the cloner, you're gonna see that the effector is there because I selected the cloner first here, okay? So I have my effector there, can select it, and you can see that there's a lot of things here that you can play with, okay? In my effector, so you can see that I have the effector's strength. I have certain parameters here that I can play with it. I have, which is the position here, I have rotation for this effector. So many ways here. Let me just rotate a little bit to be a little bit more fun. Right there, like this is pretty fine. And this one here, there you go. Right there. I have a scale of it. I can change the scale. So these effectors are really powerful. Powerful tools that you can make amazing things with this. Okay. For sake of the tutorial, I will go really simple with this, and you can play in your own. Let's go back to this orientation. It will be better for you to see. All right. So there are color modes. That's a lot of things that you can play. Usually here in order you don't change much here. Usually stay like this, but you always can explore. Cool. All right, now is the magic, okay? Now is the best thing. So when you select, you have the effector here, you have the cloner, okay? Here you have on your effector, you have a fields playing, okay? Fields here, okay? And this is where the things get really fun. And if you have the fields here, you can add, and these are the fields too, okay? You can see, look at the color field, linear fields, and you can have the linear field too. You can select here whatever field tools you want and just make it as a child of the effector, or you simply can add the fields directly here. You can see that, you see double click to create a new field. The field's gonna be inside of here. But remember, I am still inside of the effector, okay? Then my effector is selected. I'm gonna go ahead here to my fields. Actually, I'm gonna go through here, and I will add a linear field, okay? When I add my linear field, this is what actually the fields look like, okay? You can see that there's an orange outline of the fields that you can see here. Okay, and on a fields, you I'm gonna just select the fields here. You have a lot of things here. You have directions, you have basics, you have coordinates of the field. You can rotate. You can change the position. Okay, and you have also all their types of field. If you click a cylinder field. You can see that. So there's so many different types of your radio field, so a spherical field. So there's a lot of it. I'm gonna be working with the linear one, okay, for the sake of this tutorial. But there's so much that you can explore here in field. You have a remapping. This is a fun one, okay, that you can change how your field will play. So this is like a super for to explore. Have a color mapping too, if you want to change a few things here, okay? So there's a lot here, okay, on this field. So basically what the field and the effector does, which is really fun, is pretty much this here, okay? So you can change the how the forms that you are working with, you can play. So, I mean, you can do a lot of types of animations with this, okay? So what I'm gonna do here is I'm gonna just change my view. I'm gonna go to this one here, because this one is the front view. And you can see I am like this. I'm gonna just change the orientation of my field right now. I'm in the 90. I have 90 frames. I'm gonna just save this one here. Let me just copy this number. I'm gonna go ahead and go all the way to my field here. I'm gonna create a, let's go back. I'm gonna create a, let me just go to the frame 45. And I'm gonna create, gonna go here. I'm gonna record as my keyframe. And I'm gonna go ahead and record this again. Okay, so this is pretty much what I have right here now, okay? Pretty simple back and forth, okay? So let's see what it'll actually look like on the other view. So playing, so that's kind of pretty much how diffusing the effector works. And going to the effectors, as I was just showing to you, what you can do with this. So you can see that how you can play with this. Okay, you can change the scale, and you can record it on your timeline, whatever you think that will be. It'll be useful. So this is just like so great. Let me see. So you can see a little bit now what it actually look like. It's kind of like really, really, really nice animation with us. I'm just choose a floor. And a physical sky and just let me just lift up this a little bit. So this is how fun this is, okay? So so just play, take advantage of it, you know? I haven't used much the fields and the effectors, but yeah, I definitely gonna take advantage of this too for creating like a lot of fun things. So take advantage, okay? I hope you really like it. You know, you can add different types of filters, different types of materials in your work. I mean, there's so much that you can do here. Let's get a gradient here just before finishing the tutorial, just to see how fun this looks like. I mean, it just looks like really, really fun things that you can do, right? Let's get a different one because I kind of don't like this. Star, let's see, diagonal, let me see one that's look a little bit better than that one. I think that this one looks a little bit better. Looks a little bit right there. Look how fun is this. Cool. Yeah, so take advantage of this, and again, thanks so much for stopping by and subscribing to the channel. So please do it if you haven't yet. All right. I see you next time. Bye.